I couldn't believe it. I just couldn't believe that the Derrick that I've met was actually being charged for a murder.
Blow your nose. Blow your nose.
No,
all right, well, wash your hand. Come on.
I don't need my mask.
Say thank you, Daddy, for helping me out.
I met Derrick in Brooklyn through a mutual friend of ours.
I think she was at the stove cooking or something, and I was just eyeing her and saying, who's this girl? And went over and touched her, and she slapped me and said, keep your hands off me.
I thought that was weird. No one ever done anything like that to me before. I said, he got to be special.
On January 4th, 1991, Nathaniel Cash was killed in Brooklyn. I was in New Haven, Connecticut, received a phone call that the police officers were inquiring about my whereabouts and wanted to question me about his murder. I thought it was a joke, you know, somebody playing around. But ultimately, it was for real. I was arrested, charged with the death of Nathaniel Cash, tried and convicted, and sent to prison for 25 life for his murder.
But it's cold outside, so I don't want you to freeze, okay? You have a good day in school, okay? You tell everybody I said hi.
How the hell this happened? You know, how did I end up being convicted for a crime that I didn't commit? You know, I was very, very angry at the people that did it to me. You know, I was just determined at that point to find a way to prove I was innocent. You know, I spent most of my waking hours in the law library. I wasn't a guy that was running the yard or trying to be a part of the institution. I was trying to get out.
A lot of times, Derrick did a lot of his motions himself.
Love you.
Even prior to him being arrested, we started to, of course, develop feelings with one another, just being around one another. And so once he was found guilty, he just said, you know, will you continue to come visit me? Will you continue to be my support system? And I said, sure, of course. I'll be there with you until the day that you are released. I mean, I didn't know that I would be 21 years later. I went every weekend to visit Derrick. I went every weekend. And it was tiresome, but it was like each weekend I left, I felt like I left something behind. So I needed to go back the next weekend to get it again.
It was 2005 when we got married. I mean, there was no ceremony. But, you know, just to know that you're in prison and someone deemed you worthy enough to be their spouse, it was a great day for me.
Push him up, kick him back.
We tried to keep our marriage as normal as it can be in an abnormal environment. So yeah, the weather's nice, the prison may open up a yard. So in your mind, we would create, okay, we're in Central Park. You know, he'll say, I created this picnic and you know, we got all this vending machine food and you know, we're trying to make the best of it by adding humor and everything like that, but it's still not the same.
You know, the sacrifice was from day one. I mean, she was a beautiful girl, could have been with any man she wanted to be with. At times, I probably was too immature to appreciate it.
Being there for him as long as I have, it was not an easy ride. I mean, I think just as much as Derrick pushed himself to fight for his freedom was just as much as he pushed me to make sure that I pushed the people who had the power to hear emotion. I always felt like his battle was bigger than my battle.
You know, looking back now, you say, damn, that was extraordinary. You made a lot of great sacrifices for me, thank you. But at that moment, you're envious of people's freedom. You see a bird fly over a cage while you're sitting there, you say, damn, I wish I was a bird. You don't look at the limitations that the bird may have. When I went in, I had to be about 25. When I got out, I had to be 45. So, you know, at least a 20-year difference. After having a 2-year battle with the parole board, because I wouldn't have remorse or wouldn't apologize for a crime I didn't commit. The parole board ultimately released me in December 2011 and wished me luck in overturning my conviction. Walking out of that prison, I mean, it was everything. You know, having to watch a car, you know, to make sure it don't hit you. I would say one of the coolest, fastest walks that I ever took was I wanted to get out of here. I didn't want to say they made a mistake, so I wanted to hurry up and get across the street. That was the beginning of my life changing. A year after that, the Kings County District Attorney on their own investigation determined that I was innocent, and they exonerated me.
The words innocent and free rang through the Brooklyn Supreme Courthouse, giving a man, a family,
A moment of tranquility.
Let's get the monster. No, wait, get him by. Go, go.
Well, I think our future, our present, is embodied in love.
Run, come on, come on.
And when you have that unconditionally, it surpasses your human frailties. I mean, no one is perfect, but love is for us.